Hi everyone, welcome back to my class. This is Rahman Ali. I hope you all are fine. In today's class, let us start a new lesson and the name of our lesson is Public Institutions. In this lesson, we are going to study about all the different offices that are there in the mandal, in villages, in the district or in the states. In the last lesson, we have learned about a village, we have learned about the mandal, state and also about the district. And we have also learned about the different offices that work at the different places. In this chapter, we are going to see what are the different works that are there under the different officers. Okay, so we'll first study about a small village, and the name of our village is Rangapuram. So Rangapuram, it's a small village surrounded by hills. There once what happened, the flood, the river water flows into the houses of the people. The flood were caused, and due to the floods, due to the heavy rainfall, the floods causes, and due to this natural disaster, all of the houses, they get damaged. The furniture that was present in the houses, it got damaged. And after the flood gets decreases, we can see the mud that is there on the streets. We can see that the electric poles, they get damaged, and even the pipes, it also got damaged. So all these things get damaged. So who will take care of this? Who will solve this problem? Who will make the streets clean? Who will help the people? In the villages, Gram Panchayat is there to solve all the problems of the public living in that particular village. So in the Gram Panchayat, a group of members will be there. They will see whether the people are facing any problem or not. All those things can be studied. It can be seen by the members of Gram Panchayat. So Gram Panchayat is a team that is there in the small villages in order to riddle out all of the problems, in order to provide all the facilities to the public living in that village. Okay, so the institutions like schools and even the institutions like Anganwadi centers and also the hospitals, police station, all these are the places that looks towards the problem of the different people living in that village, and that problems can be solved when they reach the institutions. So the institutions that are made for the welfare of the public, these institutions, these are made by the government for the welfare of the public. So we call these institutions as public institutions. Okay, the places where the facilities are provided for the people of the village or for the public, then that places are called as public institution. ठीक है, तो कोई भी विलेज में ग्राम पंचायत टीम होती है, वो टीम के मेंबर्स जो है विलेज के पीपल को सारे फैसिलिटीज़ प्रोवाइड करते हैं. अगर उनको कोई भी प्रॉब्लम है तो ये लोग वो प्रॉब्लम्स को सॉल्व करते हैं. ठीक है, तो इसी तरीके से बहुत सारे इंस्टीट्यूशंस बनाए गए हैं विलेजेस में, स्टेट्स में, डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स में और मंडल्स में. फॉर एग्जांपल स्कूल्स है, आंगनवाड़ी सेंटर्स, हॉस्पिटल्स, पुलिस स्टेशंस, ये सारे इंस्टीट्यूशंस कहलाते हैं, क्योंकि ये सारे सेंटर्स सेटअप किए गए हैं पब्लिक के वेलफेयर के लिए. तो इसके लिए इन सारे इंस्टीट्यूशंस को हम पब्लिक इंस्टीट्यूशन कहेंगे. Okay, let us discuss about public institutions, Gram Panchayat. Let us take one example here to understand in a more better way. One person is there who lives in a village and his name is Mohan. He lives with his wife and with his children. One of his daughter's name is Aruna. So Mohan, he was not having his own ration card. Ration card can also be termed as food security card. Okay, so he was not having his ration card and he was not getting the food. He was not getting all the provisions from the ration shop. So he went to the Tehsildar office, which is located in the village. In the village, there are so many offices present for the welfare of the public, to help the poor people. So one office is there, and that office is the Tehsildar office. In this office, so many officials, so many officers will be present who help the people in order to make the ration cards, who help in doing a lot of other works too. So the officer who is controlling the work of ration card, that officer can be named as village revenue secretary. We call that officer as village revenue secretary. So Mohan with his daughter Aruna, he went to village revenue secretary officer and he asked him to make his ration card. So this village revenue secretary, he asked Mohan to write an application letter on a white paper. Now Aruna, his daughter, she wrote an application on the white paper and then she handed over that letter, that application letter, to this village revenue secretary officer. Now this officer, what he did, he take that application and he check the information, check the details of the Mohan with the details, and he compare his details with the details available with him, and then he applied that application form online. Then he asked Mohan to wait for some days in order to get his ration card. After the application form is sent to the district civil supplies office, so village revenue secretary, he sent the application to the district civil suppliers. Then this district civil suppliers, he checked all of the details that are related to the Mohan. Then he made the ration card for him, and that ration card was given to village revenue secretary, and from the village revenue secretary he got his ration card, he got his food security card. Mohan got his food security card, and after he got the card, he was getting all the provisions. He was getting the food that is available in the ration shop. So in this way, there are so many officers. There are so many offices and officers are present in the villages in order to help the poor people and also in order to work for the development of the villagers. Okay, so here Mohan, after he got the ration card, he got all the provisions. He was getting all the provisions that is necessary for his survival. Like village revenue secretary officer, there are so many other officers who worked in the different departments and also who helped the poor people of the village. Okay, so let us talk about the mandal headquarters now. We were discussing about the village. In the village, Gram Panchayat will be there in order to look after the problems of all the people living in the village. Now let us move to the mandal headquarters. We have already discussed that group of villages that forms one mandal. So in the mandal, you will be seeing an office called mandal revenue office. How Tehsildar office will be there in a village, likewise mandal revenue office will be there in the mandal headquarters, who will look the different matters, who will work for the welfare of people. This mandal revenue office, its functions include the distribution of the ration card, preview and collection of the land tax. So all those functions can be carried out by the mandal revenue officers. Let us look into the institutions and the work that is carried out by those institutions located or situated in the mandal. So the first one is मंडल परिषद ऑफिस, तो ये एक ऐसी ऑफिस है जो कि मंडल्स में प्रेजेंट होती हैं और ये ऑफिस के जो भी मेंबर्स होते हैं वो लोग ये सारे काम करते हैं, जैसा कि है प्राइमरी एजुकेशन को प्रोवाइड करना, सारे फैसिलिटीज़ प्रोवाइड करना, जैसे प्राइमरी एजुकेशन बाय विच द स्टूडेंट्स दे गेट द प्राइमरी एजुकेशन एंड दे ऑल्सो वर्क फॉर द डिफरेंट फील्ड्स लाइक एग्रीकल्चर, कैटल रेयरिंग, फिश फार्मिंग, ये सारे चीज़ों को भी ये सारे चीज़ों का भी वर्क कैरी आउट करते हैं मंडल परिषद ऑफिस। और ये लोग कोई भी अगर रोड ख़राब हो गई हो तो उसको भी कंस्ट्रक्ट करते हैं, उसको भी रिपेयर करते हैं एंड इवन दे हेल्प इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ इरीगेशन। इरीगेशन मीन्स सप्लाइंग ऑफ वाटर इन टू द फील्ड्स। इन द एग्रीकल्चरल फील्ड्स वाटर नीड्स टू बी सप्लायड, इफ वी सप्लाई द वाटर देन ओनली द क्रॉप्स कैन बी ग्रोन, राइट? सो इरीगेशन इज़ एन इम्पॉर्टेंट function that can be carried by the officers present in Mandal Parishad office. They also look into the health care facilities. They also provide health care facilities to the public. So all these functions, all these facilities are provided to the public by Mandal Parishad office. Okay, our next institution in the Mandal headquarters is police station. We all know that police station is an institution that works for the welfare of the public, that helps the people in order to reduce the crime in our society, and also the police station is an institution whose members saves and protects the public, right? So police station is an institution that maintains law and order, it reduces the crime rate, it maintains good relation with the public, and whenever the public has to complain about any crime that is going to happen or that happens in the society, they will go to the institution called police station. They receive their complaint and they conduct inquiries on that complaint in order to help the people and to make the people leave safely. So police station is an institution that safeguards child related issues and child protection agencies. They also work for the protection of children. They maintain law and order and they prevent child labor. They prevent all the social related issues in the society and they help the people to live safely and to feel protected in the society. So this is about an institution called police station. Our next institution is Mandal Revenue Office. This is an institution which is headed by the employees of Mandal Revenue Officer. Okay, so मंडल रेवेन्यू ऑफिस, तो ये वाला ऐसा इंस्टीट्यूशन है जिसको मंडल रेवेन्यू ऑफिस के जो मेंबर्स है वो लोग चलाते हैं, ठीक है? तो मंडल रेवेन्यू ऑफिस के जो भी मेंबर्स होते हैं वो सारे कंप्लेंट्स लेते हैं, जो भी पब्लिक के प्रॉब्लम्स है उसको नोट करते हैं और फिर उसके बारे में इंक्वायरी करके उनकी जो भी प्रॉब्लम होती है उसको सॉल्व करते हैं। द मेंबर्स ऑफ द मंडल रेवेन्यू ऑफिस दे रिलीव द पीपल फ्रॉम बॉन्डेड लेबर एंड दे ऑल्सो हेल्प सैंक्शनिंग द लोन्स। द फार्मर्स दे गेट द लोन्स बिकॉज ऑफ द पीपल present because of the people working in Mandal Revenue Office. So they also sanction landholder passbooks to farmers and they are the members who can also issue caste and income certificates to the public. So if any person wants to make his or her income and caste certificate, then the members of the Mandal Revenue Office can help them to get their income and caste certificate. These are the different roles played by the members of Mandal Revenue Office. I hope it's clear to you. Meet you next class. Goodbye.